Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. In this video we are solving quadratic equations as they arise in context or in problems. To start with, we need to be super good with how to solve quadratics from all the previous skills, so you really should have watched all the previous skills in this particular topic. I'd like you to pause the video at this stage, and for each of the five questions there, I don't want you to solve them necessarily. I just want you to say in a couple of sentences what you would do to solve them. This one, I would factorize. I'd factorize a common factor of x and I'd solve it using that. This one, I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to negative 12 and add up to positive 4. They'd be positive 6 and negative 2. And I'd factorize this as x plus 6, x subtract 2 is 0, and I'd solve. Now, this quadratic is not equal to 0, so I can only try and solve a quadratic by factorizing if it equals 0. I'd subtract 12 off both sides and I'd have the same one as above, and I'd solve by factorizing. This one I'd try and factorize, okay, and I would end up having to factorize that one by grouping, and then I would find my answers. The last one, when they tell you to leave your answer as a surd or give your answer to one decimal place, you know that the techniques you should be using there are either completing the square or the quadratic formula, whichever one you really want to. So they're the main techniques to solving quadratics. Usually try factorizing as long as it's equal to 0, and if it's not a whole number or if it's a surd or a decimal, then you use the quadratic formula or complete the square. Right, let's go straight into some questions that from which quadratic equations arise. Here's the first one. Please pause the video and have a go. We're told the area of this rectangle is 14 centimeters squared. Find the length of the shortest side. Now, we haven't done geometry yet on Hegarty Maths, but you should know that the area of a rectangle is going to be the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. And in this case, the base we can think of it as x add 2 and the height we can think of as x subtract 3. And we know that the area is 14 centimeters squared. So we can form an expression and an equation even for this. We could say if we take the base, x add 2, with brackets around it, and we multiply it by the height, x subtract 3, we know that the base times the height must be equal to 14. Now, this is going to be a quadratic expression here when I multiply it out, and it's going to equal 14. We know we can only solve quadratics when they're equal to 0. So let's multiply this thing out here and tidy up the left-hand side. We'd get x squared, subtract 3x, add 2x, take away 6 is equal to 14. Tidying up, we'd get x squared, subtract 1x, subtract 6 is equal to 14. Now, I can't solve a quadratic until it's equal to 0, so let me subtract 14 off both sides there, and I'm going to get myself... Now I'm in a place I know and love. This is a quadratic equaling 0. I'm going to try and factorize. Can you think of two numbers that multiply to negative 20 and add to negative 1? I can. X subtract 5, x add 4 is 0. So on the one hand, x subtract 5 is 0, or the other possible solution is x add 4 is equal to 0. Adding 5 to both sides, x is 5 is one solution, or subtracting 4 off both sides, x is negative 4. Now here's where you have to think. X, can that be negative 4? It can't be negative 4. You can't have negative length. So this one, sometimes you get a solution which doesn't make sense in the context of the question. So we're going to ignore that one, and x is 5 is going to be the answer. So this one's our answer. Now be careful, we weren't asked for x. We were asked for the length of the shortest side. This one's going to be 5 add 2, putting the 5 back in. That one's going to be 7 centimeters, and that one's going to be 5 take away 2, which is 2 centimeters. So do state your final answer. And we're done. Next example. Pause the video and have a go. We're told two numbers differ by 3 and have a product of 88. Find the possible numbers. Why don't we call the first number x? And why don't we call the other number, I don't know, like x add 3? We know that x add 3 is 3 more than x, so they differ by 3. If I have x add 3 and I take away x, I'm going to get myself 3. They differ by 3. So why can't these be our two numbers? What a good idea. And we're told they have a product of 88. So I know that x multiplied by x add 3 is going to equal 88. I need to expand this out. I'm going to get x squared, add 3x, is equal to 88. I can't solve a quadratic until one of the sides is equal to 0. So I'm going to subtract 88 from both sides. I'm going to get myself the following equation. I'm going to get x squared, add 3x, subtract 88 is equal to 0. Can you think of two numbers that multiply to negative 88 and add to positive 3? Well, I can. X add 11 and x subtract 8 are two good examples. And therefore, we'd get the answers. Well, we'd have x plus 11 is 0, or x subtract 8 is 0. And in this case, x would be negative 11. And in this case, x would be positive 8. Now, in this case, we were just said two numbers. They didn't say they were positive or negative. So both of these can be answers. So find the possible numbers. In the case where x is negative 11, we'd have the two numbers. Well, the first number is negative 11. And the other number is negative 11 add 3, which would be negative 8. And check they work. Their difference is 3. Their product is 88. In the case where we had x is 8, here, the two numbers, well, what would they be? Well, the first number was 8, and the other number was 8 add 3, which is 11. And they differ by 3 as well, and they also have a product of 88. So there are two sets of answers for this, and there we go. We have them both. Next one, pause the video. Have a go. We are told here that the sum of the squares of two consecutive integers is 145. Let the first integer, which means whole number, be x. Let the consecutive one, means the one after it, be x add 1. Now we're told if we add the squares of these, I get 145. So let me take the first one and square it. And let me add it to, because we're summing, the second one squared. And I know the answer has to be 145. Now x squared, that's just x squared. But x add 1 all squared, remember that means x add 1, x add 1. So we have to actually expand that out. So this is going to be x squared add, expand that out. I'd expect you to be able to know that's x squared add 2x add 1 is equal to 145. And collecting like terms, I've got myself here x squared add another x squared, which is going to be 2x squared. So this is going to be 2x squared add 2x add 1 is going to equal 145. Now I can only solve a quadratic until when one side is equal to 0. So I'm going to subtract 145 from both sides. I'm going to get myself 2x squared add 2x subtract 144 is equal 0. Now I'm going to try and solve it. Shall I factorize? Yep, but just before I launch into it, notice there's a common factor of 2 here, and 2 here. So I can factorize out a 2 and get x squared plus x, take away 72, and that's going to equal 0. Then factorize this expression, and I'm going to get x. I'm going to get add 9, x subtract 8 is equal 0. I've got three things multiplying to 0, this thing being 2. So either this is 0 or this is 0. So either x add 9 is 0 or x subtract 8 is 0. And therefore, in this case, I'm going to get x is negative 9 is one solution or x is positive 8 is another. And there are two solutions. Now let's check what the consecutive integers are. In the case x is negative 9, I'd have the integers negative 9. And the one after it, x add 1, is going to be actually negative 8. Be careful, you're adding 1. And if we square that, I get 81. If I square that, I get myself 64. 81 at 64 is 145. That one works. And in the case where I had x is 8, what would I have? Well, I'd have x is 8. That's the first one. And the other one I'd have is 9. 8 squared at 9 squared is 145. There are two sets of possible answers for this. And that's pretty much it for this skill in this particular video. Do know in the PDFs below there's an extra example, an even harder case for you to work through that you will find in the written section there. So do look there if you want an extra challenge. Otherwise, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.